When I was young, acting has always been an interest for me. From a young age, watching Doctor Who a lot, to watching movies on the big screen. But from starting college back in 2015, it has inspired me to achieve great things and has made me into the person that I am today.
This is going to be our most difficult thing we've ever done. We will be stretched as far as possible by Alex to come up with this world, to come up with these grotesque characters, and it's something that's going to challenge all of us, physically and mentally. I mean, it can work. It will work, definitely. But I know one thing I will never, ever ensure that I do. I'll never give up, never give in, and keep moving forward.
Just what is it that you want to do?
Well, we want to be free. We want to be free to do what we want to do. And we want to get loaded, and we want to have a good time. And that's what we're going to do.
Away, baby, let's go.
We're going to have a good time. We're going to have a party.
Surely the work will rotate around Hamlet. The possibility is that we can create in the script bleak midwinter that we are a company of buffoons or amateur dramatic actors that are putting up the show of Hamlet, or we can address the big beast directly and actually doing Hamlet.
During these first few weeks on this project, we've done a series of workshops that related to the story of William Shakespeare's Hamlet. Originally, we thought this would be our project we'd be doing together. However, as you can tell, that would no longer be case down the line to our knowledge. These workshops would consist of three areas: approaching the material, physical apparatus.
Ensemble, you have to keep this ball in the air, it cannot touch the ground.
And connecting with others. Before any exercise within the industry, any actor and group would need to go through an ensemble warm-up to ensure that they are working at full capacity and ensure that they have the right mindset and focus for the day ahead.
We'll be right back.
Some of these exercises we did during these workshops included working collaboratively in groups to produce a small improvised scene based on the stimulus that was given to us by Alex, which allowed us to think about the scene and give our own interpretation of the scene. These scenes would be the five-act structure that will make up the story of Hamlet.
I've got a few ideas. A, we find the speeches now. Okay? I've got my photocopying thing, I've got a copy of Hamlet in here, and we can just find them. Because my thought process here is, yeah! Drop off to Nando, forget all about it, come back and say, oh no! We can do it now. And then we've got a bit more time to actually look at script breakdown, but also just a few exercises when you've got a script in your hand and you kind of know the words that you want to be speaking.
Walking around a space together in different ways, with different objectives given to us by Alex, which would help us with our multitasking on stage and focusing on different things within the performance space. Another task we did involved walking around the space as characters from our chosen audition pieces to get a clear understanding of the character traits that we'd be playing with another audition. We also done a task involving sticks, which we were saying our monologues, keeping the sticks balanced and focusing on the delivery of our text. Delivering the text and auditioning our pieces, but instead of doing it naturally, going over the top and beyond the box with our audition pieces, which allowed us to play with the stimulus as actors.
Speak the speech up here!
There's Rosemary, and that's for remembering.
There's Rosemary besides, it's profound. To be or not to be.
Stick work during these weeks and practicing working with partners and occupying the space with sticks and our partners too. We also learnt about the importance of mise-en-scene, which is a French expression used to describe the design aspect of a theatre production, and done an exercise on the importance of power on stage and which side of the stage has a cold side or a warm side for the feeling of the characters. With this, we done an exercise involving the first scene of Hamlet with the two guards out on watch.
You know, what actors tend not to realise, and these guys are kind of on that journey now, is that if a show goes well, the actors get the credit. If it goes badly, everybody blames the director. If it goes well, is it really because the acting is so great? Not, you know, probably it's because the concept is brilliant. But nobody thanks the director because the director's great. Just the actor gets all the accolades. But if it goes badly, the actors, everyone's very quick to say, oh, the product was bad, the director was bad. No one's going, the actors were terrible.
Making silly faces and grotesque body language and posture, then giving these characters a voice and movement in the space and reacting to other members of the ensemble. Prior to this, we'd done an exercise with Vanessa about this called bouffoning, which would be used entirely throughout this entire performance and project.
Hello, Alex.
We also done an exercise creating a rhythm in the group and passing it amongst the ensemble to ensure that we are focusing and bonding together as an ensemble. More ensemble exercises included attempting to keep a ball up as an ensemble, testing what skills we would need to ensure that teamwork is strong amongst an ensemble, playing with another scene that Alex had given us and interpreting it to our own version of events whilst working collaboratively with a partner and brainstorming different ideas for the scene and delivering it to the ensemble.
Conception is a blessing, but you don't know how.
doing different vocal exercises to ensure that our tonality, pitch and tone is key, and helping our vocal muscles in general by not straining them too much.
Try to understand that there is, we are two parts of our lung. It's the lower and the top.
More practicing working with a partner involving keeping the ball in the air whilst two partners are working collaboratively to ensure that they can keep it up and adapt into their surroundings of the situation.
Down here, without talking. And the ball should travel, so this is the script, this is the text. You're both working in a dialogue to move the script, the text, the concept. The ball has to travel throughout your body.
We also was walking around the space with a partner, with one of their partner's eyes shut, with the other partner guiding them with energy that they're creating using their hands, and just a basic trust and instinct together. Our final exercise we did as part of our workshop section involved throwing balls amongst the ensemble, ensuring that it never touched the ground. If this happened, or if any of the ball exercises we did touch the ground, if one of us failed, we all failed together as an ensemble.
Whoever's got the ball, if you can see someone with the ball, try and get their eye contact.
During these exercises we've done over the last few weeks, I have felt the importance of ensemble work when working together and collaboratively on different productions and performances, and whether it be even in a workshop scenario, how we can incorporate some skills what we can use into performance. And I've also picked up on certain weaknesses that I've learned from doing these workshops over the last few weeks. These things I'll need to improve on will include having more confidence in my performing, going bigger with certain actions and gestures, and I was able to understand the story elements of Hamlet and the themes that are represented within the story. Now, one of the things we'll be doing as part of this unit of work will be auditioning for this performance of Hamlet, or whatever we do in the end. And so Alex asked us to choose a piece from Hamlet to audition for. One of the things I looked at was the infamous to be or not to be speech. To prepare for this, I looked at David Tennant's interpretation on the speech, and when undergoing weeks of preparation,
to sleep. To sleep, perchance to dream. Aye, there's the rub.
And then done it. Overall, coming from this monologue, I felt pretty good with how it all went. All the things that I wanted to do within the monologue, it all happened, it all fell into place. And one of the main things I felt I worked on in, throughout the weeks that showed, was the mindset of the monologue, because I interpreted it as a suicide attempt, and I felt I was in the correct mindset for it. There was a moment there in which I made the choice to throw a fake phone, which built up to a point in the music, but I don't think it worked, and Alex don't think it worked as well, so I felt that was almost forced acting rather than it being in the moment. So it's something I planned, but it didn't execute how I wanted it to. But from that, I felt pretty good with how the overall product felt of the monologue. Then we found out a real surprise to all of us, something we wouldn't be expecting to find out.
Thanks for the work. And what? The idea to give you Hamlet was to give you a task that was bigger than you.
You've lied to us.
Yes.
Yeah. 3 years of it.
I know, right?
I can't believe you've done it.
So the thing that we would be doing would be a play called The Visits by Friedrich Durrenmatt, which was written in 1956 in Germany and focused on a town of people who are at their poor financial end, who are visited by a woman who has great financial wealth that the town requires. But in order for that town to gain this wealth, they must follow one condition, and one condition alone. This was actually a genuine surprise to all of us. We would not be expecting this, to go from Hamlet to The Visit. But I feel that this was a good surprise to be sure, but a welcome one, to be accepted amongst all of us, and a challenge to do, and we can do it.
A bunch of actors sitting around the table with a script and try to make a sense of what they are going to do for the first time. Let's try to read the script. Reading is needed to understand.
On the first few days of our creative process, we done a script read through with some members of the ensemble, but not all of them. This was due to certain members not turning up due to different reasons, but in an industry setting, this wouldn't be acceptable, as every member must be committed to the project with 100% enthusiasm and commitment, and can leave an impact upon the ensemble.
Folk song with the amended word. Word to this song will be found in the back of the book.
During the next week, we would find out who our cast would be, so who we will be playing within the play. And I found out I wouldn't be playing the character of the Burgomaster. I'll be playing the character of Toby, who is one of the gangsters and one of Claire's entourage. So when she comes on, I'm always with Claire carrying her big sedan chair. And I'd be a gangster looking at how to make myself grotesque and go big with my actions. On the next week, we actually started devising our first scene, which would involve the four men sitting on blocks and the townspeople coming in on a train from one side to another. This was a difficult first to get a grasp with, but our assistant director and Alex both helped us out with how we could plan it and how we could go from one side of the stage to another in a completely over-the-top way while staying formally as a train.
So it's quite hard to get everyone to listen, to be on board, but also thinking of really good creative ideas that have a lot of substance to them that you can go into and direct really well because you know what you're doing. So that's definitely been one of the challenges, and also getting everything done in a short time frame. But I love directing because it's so cool to bring ideas to life and collaborate with all these like incredible, talented people. So yeah.
During one of the weeks of our devising process, we actually had the entire week off. This was due to harsh weather conditions causing the buses and the trains to become cancelled for all of us, which did impact us, which would mean we'd lose a week on our project. And it would mean we'd have to work a little bit harder to get back to where we wanted to be from losing that week. We also done some things involving character work, so we looked at working with different characters and started creating some of our own scenes whilst we was off, and also whilst in the session, so then we can start thinking about what scenes we want to include, what scenes we want to adapt, and how I can do them in a grotesque and bouffant way. One of the things I'd be looking at for personally with developing my character of Toby would be Beetlejuice, so how grotesque, and Tim Burton in general, just the whole hair, eyes, mouth, and everything that relates to the importance of characters in Tim Burton films, and how I can apply them into a gangster, but an over the top one.
Ah, well, I attended Juilliard. I'm a graduate of the Harvard Business School. I travel quite extensively. I lived through the Black Plague, and I had a pretty good time during that. I've seen The Exorcist about 167 times, and it keeps getting funnier every single time I see it!
Not to mention the fact that you're talking to a dead guy. Now what do you think? You think I'm qualified?
Seeing as this entire performance would be based on grotesque characters and a grotesque world, Alex asked us to find two images that related to our internal and external feelings for our character and our own interpretation on how we see them.
We have a problem with this, as I said, so the costume doesn't make you a monk. To say, the costume doesn't change you. As actor, we think exactly the opposite. The costume makes you a monk.
For this, I found two images. One of these being the external character with a dog muzzle. And I felt this character could almost be like a dog obeying every word of Claire Zachanassian. And the second image, well, that's just chaos. It's the way how I see Toby's internal feelings. The importance of images in performing arts when it comes to character work is very crucial, as you want to have a reference point to know what your character is exactly supposed to look like. So the clothes, hair, their teeth, their eyes and everything, and having these images to relate to will help us explore our characters and create them in a grotesque manner. There's also an idea to put in a song. This song will be used in the finale of our show to help close it off, almost as a funeral march for Alfred Ill when he is inevitably killed. I feel that the importance of this song we're singing allows us to tell the powerful message of how we shouldn't be corrupted to take a life and be greediness in this world, especially as one of the main themes of the story of The Visit is the theme of greed amongst society.
Like playing like a 65-year-old dude, that's quite hard, playing a 65-year-old man. A load of lines that are like, it's very intense. Throughout, so like characterization wise, it's different and quite exciting.
When it comes to productions, one of the things that must be thought about must be the character. And for this, we decided to have a costume test for our first attempt in making costumes. For this, myself and Claire's entourage will be wearing white, and the entire town will be wearing dark colours to symbolise the chess piece board right at the beginning of each act. And I feel this costume test worked, but there will be things that need changing as well, which would be implemented.
The good news is that we are starting to go in the right direction. The very good news is some of you actually has already a costume, so I can already say, okay, that's fine. For woman number one, woman number two, fine. Your makeup have to change. We have to be more white, etc. But it's good. For Doctor, I have a mask for you that you will wear at the beginning.
With our costumes, we decided to go over the opening parade scene involving the lift of Claire Zachanassian and Alfred Ill. However, when it comes to performing for myself, one of the things I ain't strong in is physically lifting people. And for this, one of the things my character will be doing a lot will be lifting Claire. For this, it didn't exactly go well the first time, but I'm planning to do a lot of exercise to try and build myself up to this character, to this big, grotesque character. And if not, there's always shoulder pads. During this blocking stage, we decided to block all of Act 1, as in the key scenes from the beginning of the entire play up to the end of the Kalashnikov scene in Act 1. And for this, we decided to just block the first act once we got it all nailed down and perfect, so then we could remember it and progress on to the second act. However, one of the things that we know would keep letting us down would be learning lines, which is important, especially as by this time we would need to be off all lines to progress onto the next stage of our play.
Create some
stopping picture that is completely unhappy. And even like your psychological gesture.
Well, I've been learning things I didn't really know I usually do, because my sort of acting style is quite normal, I use my own voice, but I'm sort of really grotesque, so I'm like going from our distinguished guest will be arriving at 1:13 local to our distinguished guest will be arriving at the 1:13 local. It's very, very different from what I'm used to, so I'm coming out of my comfort zone. We all are, really, aren't we? We're all doing things that we would never really do. It's something that we find uncomfortable, but if we're uncomfortable, then we're doing it right.
I always try to be a comedic actor. It's always something that's there. It's never different to me. But I always, when I act, it's either going this normal, my normal voice, or we do a bit posh, don't we? But in this, I wanted to be a little bit different. I wanted to push my vocal cords, so I became Richard Nixon a bit. It's a bit different to Richard Nixon, of course. And then I went to, yes, hello. I'm very old and, yeah, German. I had need to work on the German accent. It's kind of the English slipping into the German words. But I digress.
So yeah, the course, really. Yeah, so on the visit, it's a great play to work on, I think. It's something I'm not used to. I saw something like a bootleg on it, apparently a musical or something like that.
It is different.
It's meant to be a musical, so we have got a bit of singing as well, and the singing itself is like a three-part harmony. And, well, it's... Well, harmonies itself are really difficult, so to do it with a whole class is, considering we're not musical theatre, it's much, much harder. So, yeah, it's been really challenging.
It has been challenging. Probably the most challenging bit is keeping it grotesque, because there's parts where you can break into naturalism, and we don't want to be naturalistic, we need to be something separate than from human.
And you lose focus of that sometimes, because we get distracted, or as it's a big class for our director, Alex and Anto, it's, you know, they're talking to somebody and then we're doing our own sort of thing.
Yeah.
So Alex decided to make certain cuts in Act 1 for timing purposes and also for the amount of lines that have to be learnt by different members of the ensemble, and also for scenes taking too long to develop whilst we have the time we have to develop what we have so far.
Page 18, after Clarice left, the major, at last, the file bell deleted. Take off that. We started immediately from... We ain't good and we can smell it. Yes.
Cuts like this may need to happen within the realm of performing arts because of either timing, pacing, or the amount of time we have to devise the rest of the scenes, and whether it makes sense, whether we would have time to start the work rather than develop what we have so far. One of the things we also did was revisit the Zorba dance we created and added different elements of dance, lifts, levels and group work within the dance to help make it more diverse rather than just a stale dance for everyone to see and a little bit of a mess, so then we could also tweak it up and perfect it too. As the weeks progressed, we had finished the end of Act 1 and started blocking Act 2 whilst going over certain elements. However, by this time we were not all off script. This was a major challenge, seeing as we couldn't allow ourselves to play with the scenes we were given. It wouldn't allow us to play with the circumstances we were in. It wouldn't allow us to just explore who our characters are rather than restrict ourselves to lines that are said and how they're being said as well. We also started blocking certain parts of Act 2 involving the mayor, the policeman, the pastor, Ill Shop, and many different figures within Act 2, and also the Black Panther chase happening in the background just before the end of Act 2, in which we will be creating this massive group scene involving the group against Ill.
Oh, challenges, okay. I'd probably say developing a character to a certain standard.
Also during this time, whilst we're blocking the end of Act 3, Alex has asked me to step in for the role of the butler and the bailiff, and has asked me to understudy and learn the lines for the butler and bailiff. Understudying is crucial within performing arts, and especially a show like this, in which you've got to be able to know all the lines, pick up on all the grotesque natures, applying your own thing and create something that you know will work for this world. And for this, I know I've got a lot of work to do when it comes to the butler and bailiff, as well as keeping up my routine for Toby and also the journalists as well.
The challenges, I think working with people, keeping productive and bouncing off each other's character during development of our own is a good one. I found it quite challenging, but we're getting there.
In time to blocking the end of Act 2, we did it in a way in which we'd have Council of Eight walking in between Alfred Ill and almost coming on in a grotesque way, which was doing which Alex was trying to install to us to try and get back into our grotesque characters. And for this, we all looked at different levels. We'll start off with, went to our sides and then started walking with purpose from one side to the other, attempting to stop Ill. And to develop this even more, we decided to add elements of taking off Ill's shirt, marking him with charcoal for foreshadowing of what's going to happen later on with the play. And for blocking the end of Act 2, I am feeling a little bit optimistic, but not as much as I hope we would be, knowing where we are now and the fact that not everyone has known all their lines yet. If we knew our lines weeks ago, we could play with the scenes. We could go big, have fun with the given scenes, but right now we've got one more act to block, and once that's blocked, we will be allowed to play.
I would have to say, again, getting rid of that third eye. Definitely, I think we've all come into this with a massive third eye, being like, oh, you look stupid, but really it's been really kind of helpful to get rid of that and just completely let yourself go and create some really cool and funny and weird characters out of it.
Yeah, that was probably the biggest challenge.
Yeah, as well.
As well as the ensemble work, like, because obviously in ensembles you need to have everyone, so as soon as, you know, someone's not in or someone's not listening, you know, it's all about, you know, working as a team and trying to move forward as a team to, you know, achieve, like, the show we're trying
especially,
to put on.
Yeah, especially with the type of show we're trying to put on. It's very physical, very out there, very big, so,
It's not that we can't do it, you know, like, if we all keep working together, keep positive, keep working the way we're going, like, who's saying we can't do it?
Exactly.
So we met with our production team, who we'd be working with on this production, to go over the different elements of props and settings we would like to use within the play. And for this, we decided to tell them what we need.
The newspaper cannot be Metro, The Sun, Mirror, or any other. The Guardian.
Also, within this time, we finished blocking the entirety of Act 3, from the journalists entering Woods of Comradesville to the final scene involving Ill's death. Now from this, knowing that the entire play has been blocked, the things we all need to work on will be character work, it will be getting all the timings right on different things, and it will be the production element side as well. So all the costume, the makeup, the props, and getting all that secure.
Pull yourself together! Get impressed! Get in touch with the press! You're running out of time, for goodness sake!
I'm not fighting anyone!
I think we've learned a lot from watching other people and what they brought to it.
Definitely.
I think it gives you like a good like to get rid of your third eye and just get on with it. Sorry.
It's also cool to kind of see how other people can push themselves because I think we've discovered that like a lot of people like who usually will hide behind like shadows and other people will like kind of come forward because they're known for doing it. You get people like Patrick, for example, who's definitely like pushed himself as their main character.
Now the thing we'd be moving on to next would be rehearsing and just going over the entire play with all the cues, costume, makeup, sets, props, and every little detail that we'll be using within the play. And by doing this, it allows us to really get to know our characters, to get to know what our characters are going to be like, interacting with others, and also can work on creating the relationships, building the characters, and just getting every detail we want refined down to the bone, the way we want it to be throughout this play.
So, in general, the first act, you have captured maybe the rhythm of the first act. In the second act, not at all. You become naturalistic, you lose completely irony, your characterization is more, and it's mostly, not just, but mostly because you don't know your lines. And, well, I don't know when you're going to learn the lines in this case. We have 3 weeks from the show. Not that we can go on stage with our script.
Yeah, and I found it very hard to find my character, but I took inspiration from Jake's mirror.
Also, the timings, like first man and that, having to be like quick and not dragging it out.
Yeah, it's
thinking
like remembering
accents and.
Yeah, it's also remembering that when you're being someone and you're saying a line, you need to remember that that is meant to be the first time you say the line. You're not supposed to remember it.
Now as we're nearing the end of our devising process, it'll just be a case of rehearsing what we've done. I feel happy where we've blocked everything, how we have everything all ordered and how we have our scenes go. But now it's just a case of rehearsing what we have to do. And just going over it day by day with all different casts and getting all the lines, the cues, and start working and building our characters from scratch. Now throughout the entirety of the half term, we wouldn't have Alex as he would be off in Italy with the HNCs. However, we would be doing different workshops and attempting to fix elements of the performance. So one of the things we actually fixed was the train sequence. Instead of having us all scattered about and the way it wasn't working before, we all clumped together looking more grotesque and more abnormal and very unnatural, which is what we wanted to do. Another exercise we also did during this week was every morning we just went crazy. The idea was that we were out in Ibiza. That's what the scene similar was. We were out in Ibiza and we were just going to have a party and just go crazy, go insane, not give a care about what we think we're doing. This helps us release ourselves from our third eye, which is what has been holding us back from our grotesque characters.
I'm gonna do better.
It makes you think like what kind of changes you can add to make your own one unique and you just make your own have your own take on it.
What we did this week, learning from our half term with Sarah Mayhew, is we applied all the learning we had got about the grotesque workshop and ignoring our third eye and doing run through after run through of the show. On the next day, we also done a radio drama to increase the tempo of the play. This would help us with understanding what the tempo is going to be on the play, knowing the timings and everything.
Woods and winds and branches roaring and sighing like surf on the beach. Just like it has to be. Just like it was. If only life wasn't suspended, my little sorceress. If only life hadn't torn us apart.
You wish that.
Just that. Nothing else. You know I've always loved you. The same cool white
man. Wrong, no, no, prosthetic!
And then we also looked at working on our characters and we done one run through up to halfway act two. However, we all felt that the energy was dying down halfway through the show. But the reason was this, is because we were stopping this and starting each scene. And to know where we are now with our characterisation working, the next thing we would have to do would be working on the play itself and fixing key areas and production details before we go up to Grays to do our tech runs. We also looked at one in particular scene, so looking at the grotesqueness, the pacing and the timings of our ending of our second act, which we called Cinnamon. And to nail this, to make sure it's all nailed down with the timings and everything, helps make the scene flow and help raise his attention to what it was.
What we call it is a play position. So you can gaining a play position or losing a play position when you're on stage. Be careful. You at least, it's not a problem to lose it or gain it or lose it. It's not a problem. As long as you understand that you are doing it. As long as you understand that you are in that position. When you are not reacting, for example, as a chorus in the background, is the moment of death where you are taking a break. It's the moment of death where you're taking a break from the play position. So you're not playing the game anymore. You're not sustaining the actor that is doing the main part. And you look just like an idiot. Because he's alone. Instead, you as a chorus, you are constantly working with a play position. You are constantly keeping that going. Okay. It's the last things that I wanted to tell you. Stay play position. Stay always play position. Stay always stupid. The more stupid you will be, the better actor you will be, guys. The more serious of believing that you are so important and you say things that are so important, the more dead you will be. Because, by the way, we are actors, i.e. clowns.
And after Alex's final speech to all of us, it would be Tech Week. And then we'd be performing it. From all these weeks of rehearsal, I think we're ready to pull this off. I think we're ready to get on and perform this, stand up for it, and give it our absolute best and go over the top and just be insanely grotesque.
Oh, Cinnamon, where you gonna run to? cinnamon, where you gonna run to? Where you gonna run to? All on that day, will I run to the rock? Please hide me and run to the rock. Please hide me and run to the rock. Please hide me, Lord, all on that day. But the rock cried out, I can't hide you, the rock cried out. I can't hide you, the rock cried out. I ain't gonna hide you, God, all on that day. I said, rock, what's the matter with you, rock? Don't you see I need you, rock? Lord, 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 all on that day. So I ran to the river. It was bleeding, I ran to the sea. It was bleeding, I ran to the sea. It was bleeding all on that day. So I ran to the river. It was boiling, I ran to the sea. It was boiling, I ran to the sea. It was boiling all on that day. So I ran to the Lord. Said, go to the devil, the Lord said, go
I love you all so much.
Oh, I'm trying not to think about it.
Bye!
Bye! Hi everyone, I'm really sad that we're going to be leaving this year, and on a serious note, for the second time, you all become like my family, and I've never had a group of friends as close as you guys, so thanks for the community, and I'll maybe see you, maybe not, so.
Hi, so I just want to say to everyone, you're all amazing. I've had the best 2 years of my life, you all. And I've found some amazing friends in this class. I just want to wish everyone the best of luck for the future. Keep in touch. Text me, hit me up. Yeah, so goodbye. Lots of love.
It's been like 2 years. It don't feel real to be saying goodbye to anyone. Like, you go through school and that's 5 years. And like, everyone talks about, like, you, like, the friends you made in 5 months is like, they can be like more everything. They can mean more to you than like the people you've known for like 5 years, and it's so true. Like, I've known these guys for 2 years, like all of you guys for 2 years, and it's like, I know that I won't forget any of you. Like, I love each one of you individually for like something different. Like, there's something different about every one of you, so it's like made me laugh and made me smile. Like, you've all taught me something. So to be saying goodbye to you is like just insane. I don't really want to say goodbye. As much as I bang on about like how I don't like college, it's not that I don't like college, it's that I don't like, it's like, I miss you guys so much.
No, these past 2 years have been fucking great. Been fucking brilliant. I never thought I'd actually like find people I'd be able to connect with like I did with like these 2 years. Amazing. Like, I've got someone like Patrick who's helped me throughout most of these 2 years. People like Alex has helped me. Everyone else helped me by building my confidence, by just supporting me, just even saying hello. But
it's been a hell of a ride. It's been fun, really fun. I've met some amazing people, really amazing people. Everything was good. I don't really want it to end.
Yeah.
It's going to be sad.
It's going to be very sad knowing I'm leaving you guys. And I'll try and keep in touch as much as I can in the future.
Yeah, and just remember that the sky's the limit. And,
I need most of you. I'm kidding.
And
and by the way, we're now going to recreate the last scene in 30 Reasons Why. Okay, ready?
Yeah.
Okay.
I've never seen this, but...
Me neither. Let you shove it on my arms, Patrick. Okay.
I've had such an amazing 2 years. I've learned so many new things and made so many new friends, and I wouldn't change it for the world. And I just want to say thank you to everyone, because I've had such a good time. Goodbye.
To sum up what I want to say, I just want to say a massive thank you to every single one of you for making these past 2 years the best time of my life so far. Each and every one of you are so talented, so lovely, so kind, absolutely hilarious. All of you make me laugh every single day. And I really don't know what I'm going to do without you guys. I'm so proud of everything that we've achieved as a group, and I wish every single one of you all the best in whatever you do in the future. You're all so fab, and this little tiny weeny sun bum loves every single one of you so, so much. Just thank you. That's all I can say. Okay. Bye guys, love you.
Oh, hello, it's me, it's Isabel. I'm in my pajamas.
Is it a train, is it a plane?
No, Isabel. And I want to say goodbye to everyone, and that these have been the best years of my life. And you're all funny people, and you're all genuinely people I like and I'm gonna miss. And just thank you. Thanks for all the banter. It won't be forgotten.
Hello, daddies. I just want to say goodbye to all of you, and I'm going to miss all of you so much. The last 2 years have been my favourite thing ever. And yeah, we miss you all so much. So, love you all. Goodbye.
Okay, college has been lit. You guys are lit, and I loved every minute of it. You know, bar like dumb shit, like, you know, coffee machines being slapped and shit like that. But still, like, it's been sick, and I'm so happy yet sad to be leaving. You know what I mean? I'm really like, it's hitting my chest. I have made some memories and some friends that are gonna last me a long time. I'm grateful that I have learned so much, man. I really have, despite the fact that I never really did much coursework. Like, forget all that, I still learned a lot, you know what I mean? This whole process has just been one big fat meme. Like, this whole our whole class is a meme, but anyways, I'm leaving content, I'm leaving happy, and I wish all of you guys the best. Love from your only black friend, Mel.
Hi guys, we are here at the Leavers Mill. I just want to thank all of you so much for these past 2 years. No, I am not but honestly, I have not known a group of friends to be like as close as what we have been. It's been amazing. So thank you for history it is to you.
Oh, back again? Such an amazing bunch. Thanks for everything. Love you. This is my goodbye message. Bye bye.
Okay, there's a lot of things I want to say, but I doubt I've got enough time. But I wish I was a lot more confident talking to you guys. I'm sure all of you guys are going to like do pretty well in your chosen fields. I mean, God knows where we'll all end up. I mean, no, me, I'll probably end up like busking in the street or some crap like that. But I hope all of you have an amazing life. If I never see any of you again, it's been great knowing you. And Alex, what do you think to you specifically?
My name is Ren, and I have lived many lives.
It's a level 2 throwback. It's like this stupid character we were. Yeah, and he's mouthing motherfucker to me right now. One thing I'll go, woo! That's me getting going back. I'm gonna miss all of you guys.
These 2 years have been the best, and a good experience. As a group, we've always had our ups and our downs, but we've always gotten through them. You've pushed me from my weakness all the way up to my strength. And we've always got the best memories. I'm going to miss you all, and the best of luck in the future. Bye.
I don't want to say goodbye because I don't believe in them. But I do know that we won't be spending the time that we have forever, so it's quite emotional. I just want everyone to know that I wish them all luck and I hope they will do well in the future. Keep on dreaming, guys.
These last 2 years have allowed me to grow so much, and I hope everything you want in the future happens. Of course, I'm a few shots of vodka down the line, so if you ever need me, bring a bottle with you. If anything, I would like to impart some wise words from the manliest man of anime. And he says, believe in the me that believes in you. Goodbye.
This is a time when we were in college, and when you all watch this, you probably won't be. And that's very sad. And I want to tell everyone that I'll miss you all. And I love all of you so much. And I know everyone else feels the same way. If you don't, then you should have left earlier. Because I'll miss you all so much. All of my heart. Peace out. Love you.
Come on, call me Gerald! Oh,
did it, kind of. Anyway.
Bye.
Ladies and gents, we've come to a long, we've had a long ride. 2 years.
It's been 45 years since you last left this little place. Founded by Alex Chettur.
Fucking knew I shouldn't have done it. So bad. I basically just want to say, like, on a serious note, I'm going to really miss everyone. Because you were all really, really great. And I would get upset if I tried doing this seriously. But I'll be you next thing, so I'll be right. If I say I'm hurt, I might start winning up.
Well, I'm staying here, so it's,
yeah, okay. It's not my but anyway, I just want to say I love you all very much, and you've been a very essential part of my life. And it's going to be weird not going back, and I'll miss you all very, very much. Go nice.
Bye. That's me done.
Well, I tried to find a suitable place to make this video, so it really meant a lot to me and to a lot of you as well, but I just couldn't find it, so here I am, sat on my toilet. Because this is the only place I can have the room to think and shit and be free with what I need to say, because sound insulation stops the plopping of the water from my massive load of leavings. What the fuck am I talking? Yeah, so I'd like to say thank you all so much for being there for me. I am eternally grateful. Eternally grateful. So much so I've decided to give you all something of great. Yeah?
Can you hurry up? I want to get in.
I'm trying to record a video for the people in my class. Is your shit that important?
Yeah.
I'll be right back. So I've decided, after a lot of thought, that I would give each and every one of you the opportunity to take a free 10p carry bag at Home Bargains, because I'm so thankful.
It's not until you fall that you fly. When your dreams come alive, you're unstoppable. Take a shot, chase the sun.
Well, well, well. Hello there. You finally made it to the end of your course. Finally made it through 2 years of hard work, and for some of you, 3 years of hard work. People have joined, people have left, but throughout all of it, the people sat in this room are the people who have made it this all this way. Made it this far, I was going to say. All I can say for you lot is well done. Well done for everything you've done, well done for the hardships you've faced, well done for the journey you've made. And you should pat yourselves on the back and have a big warm congratulation to yourselves, because you made it, and own that pride. But, and there's always a but, this is only one part of your long journey, and a long journey that will go like that, so make the most of it. Take your time. Be happy, remain calm, and always remain positive. It's a big negative world out there, so all I can say, drink lots, and I'm someone who doesn't drink. And on a serious note, and all the jokes aside, I'd just like to say thank you. Thank you to everyone from a spectator point of view, an audience perspective. Thank you for your hard work that you've put up. Thank you for all that you've done for this college and how you've worked together as a group. And from a peer note, thank you for everyone who I've had the pleasure to work with. I wish I could have worked with all of you. Sadly and unfortunately, I haven't, but who knows? Maybe one day. We're all going into the same industry, right? And to round it all off, because Alex wanted this to be a minute 30 and I've gone over, be safe. Take care, be healthy and happy, live life to the fullest, but spare a laugh every now and then. Don't take yourselves too seriously, take the work seriously, you know, and be kind whenever you can be, because at the end of the day, we've all got to get along somehow, even you, hashtag lead.
Very, very proud of you. So I hope to see you all into the industry, or in whatever industry you would like to be, successful, happy, full of joy, full of money, not like me, don't become like me. And I really, really wish the best to all of you.
But Alex, in your film,
invite me
to all our parties.
Obviously, this doesn't go to my wife. Invite me and just send me one ticket. And I will engage some 22 years old when I'm there.
So I've been asked to do a goodbye video. God, it's gonna be tough. Here we go. Goodbye. I was joking, obviously. Oh my God, I'm so funny. Anyway, goodbye. Yes, sorry. Oh, okay. So, words of wisdom to walk away with. 1, don't be late. 2, be prepared. 3, learn how to walk away. 4, swear and eat cake often, not always together. 5, the best one, don't be dicks. Oh God. Ooh, this is quite tough actually. Maybe we shouldn't say goodbye. Maybe I will just kidnap you and we can just do warm-ups for the rest of our lives together. Oh. Guys? No, guys? No, no, come back. I was joking, I promise. I wouldn't kidnap anyone. Oh, guys. Okay. It's been great. Bye.
And so, that's it. This is... Yeah. I just want to wish everyone the best for the future, the absolute best. You are all an inspiration. And none of this, none of what I'm doing here would have been possible for all of you. You all inspire me to achieve great things, and I'm thankful to have worked with everyone on this course. The last 2 years, they've been... We've had some highs, we've had some lows, but we've got through it. We are there. So all of you moving on to university, to apprenticeships, to jobs, just getting out there in the world, just prepare the very best of luck to you. You'll be fine. And as all of you know, I love the quote. So, you are the author of your life. Never allow someone else to take your pen and rewrite your life.
Tonight the apple falls in time. We'll sing along with Auld Lang Syne and throw confetti high up into space. Tomorrow morning when we wake, this town will be a different place, and the past will wash away like coffee stains. We could be kings of the world, on top of the nation. It's a celebration of the moments to come. The city's on fire, we're holding up lighters, raising them higher, and we've only begun. Oh, yeah, like New Year's Day.
like New Year's Day. Another year we've been divine. We'll play it back in slow rewind and laugh about the cold and bitter nights. We'll root our way on maps of stars, hold them tight to fragile hearts, and keep our friends forever by our side. We could be kings of the world, on top of the nation. The celebration of the moments to come, the city's on fire. We're holding them lighters, raising them higher, and we've only begun. This way, no regrets on New Year's Day. Morning breaks.
Kings of the world.